Should I assume you didn't mean it like that?
Hey girlies, it's me, Enoch, back at another video, and this week we're doing a story time about how I was an experiment slash I got my high school crush. Another one, right? So yeah, let's go ahead and hop into the story. So boom, it's the summer of 2019, girl, what the fuck? It's the summer of 2019. I just graduated high school and I'm working through YMCA. This particular day, I was waiting on my mother to get there. So instead of waiting outside, I went into the gym area. If you ever been to the Houston Texans YMCA, you know what I'm talking about, right? So it's like, you know, just a gymnasium, girl, where all the niggas go play basketball.
Right.
So I'm in there. At this time, I was not on hormones, girl. I was not on anything, girl. I was a fat girl, too. So I was just sitting in the corner because, girl, anybody want to talk to me, girl? I'm just sitting in the corner, like, looking how I'm looking, girl. And so then, I'm in the corner, and sometimes I just look up, right? And I look up, and I see one of my high school crushes. We're gonna call him Squid. So Squid was over there playing basketball. Now, let me describe Squid for y'all. Squid is this short boy, pretty eyes, caramel color. He was, girl, I am 5'10". He was probably 5'6", probably 5'6", 5'7", maybe-ish, because I'm 5'10", he was shorter than me. So this, you know, this little boy thing, I'm like, oh my god, that is Squid over there playing basketball. Now, of course, my bitch had to stand it out because, bitch, I always thought he was cute and he was fine. Like, when I first got to school and I saw him, I was like, ugh. Now, I didn't get a chance to miss him in high school because he was, one, I don't think he was interested in me. He wasn't looking my way. Two, because he graduated early. He was a class 2018. I'm class 2019. So he graduated early. And after that, girl, that shit went to dust. And three, he was talking to one of my associates at the time, and I was kind of like real good associates with her, so I didn't want to, you know, fuck with her man. That shit's tacky to me. But anyway, so I finally saw him. I was like, oh fuck, that's Squid. Like, y'all, like, okay. So in the back of my head, I'm thinking, girl, now we're out of high school. Okay, we're out of high school. If we fooled around, I mean, I'm pretty sure, I feel like once you're out of high school, a lot of people do a lot of shit they wouldn't do in high school because they're out of high school. You know what I'm saying? Like, at this point, we everyday, everybody's just regular ass grown folk. Really give a fuck who you fool around with. And even if you do, it ain't like there could be like real, real bad consequences unless you work with the person or, you know, something like that. Like, unless you know them. Girl, who really gives a fuck, right? So whatever like that. So I take note of that night. So I remember I followed him on Instagram. So that next morning I texted him because I know I was gonna be at work anyway. And I feel like, you know, niggas, they come to the basketball court pretty often, right? So I texted him that morning. No, sorry, that's a lie. Let me back it up. I texted him that morning. Well, I DM'd him that morning. I was like, hey, what's up? How you doing? Now that was in the morning. Now time went on, girl. My whole day went on. My whole shift went on, and I went to like an evening shift. So it was like 1 to 5, right? But I texted him that morning around like 6 something, right? I texted him 6 a.m. He didn't say nothing from until whatever 12, and then I worked the 5, still no answer. Then I got a DM back at basically at 6:00 p.m. Like 6:00 p.m. right? I think it was 6:00 p.m. I don't remember, but I know it was around like when I was getting off. And I got a DM from him. He was like, hey, how you doing? How you been? I said, good. You know, just chit chat. Now, this time he was not in the gym because I went in the gym, girl, because I was looking for him. But he wasn't in the gym. He said, I'm moving ahead of myself. So I was in the gym. I was texting him because I was looking for him to be in the gym. Now, I didn't know. I knew he was in the gym because I feel like that was a, like, kind of a stalker move, bitch. That shit's creepy as fuck. So I didn't let him know I was in the gym, but I was like, oh, you know, basically I was just texting him. I'm saying all this to say, I was just texting him like, how you doing? I'm doing good. Da, 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 da. You know, just conversating, nothing crazy, just harmless conversation. Just getting to you know, get back on each other's radar, right? And that happened for like a week. We're texting for a week. And then after that, the next week, he said he was coming to the gym. Kind of to hoop around with like that. I said, okay, cool. So I looked at my schedule and, bitch, a girl was working. So I said, okay, boom, boom, bit. That's all it needs to know. So it was on, I want to say a Tuesday, I was working, he came to the gym. And again, it's another evening shift. So I didn't get there until like 1 something. Well, this evening shift is from 1 to 5. So it was from 1 to 5, evening shift. And he was in the basketball court. And I texted him, I was like, hey, I know you said you're going to be here. I just got off my shift. I'm waiting for my ride. I'll be upstairs if you want to talk in person. That's me texting. So he said, all right, cool. When I get done, you know, hooping, I'll meet you up there. I said, okay, cool, bet. And he's waiting for his ride too, so. I went upstairs. I watched him play for a little bit longer from where you can see, because you can upstairs there's a window where you can see down basketball court, and I was watching him play a little bit. I wasn't watching play that much, girl, because I don't give a fuck about basketball that much. So your girl was just watching, but on her phone, but watching. And after that, he came upstairs, and it was just me and him up there alone. I mean, the gym was kind of closing down, so of course, you know, people weren't really coming upstairs, up downstairs, and plus at a certain time, and a lot of people upstairs. It was kind of surprising he snuck up there, but yeah. So, I was sitting down. I saw him coming, girl. Of course, my giddy ass. I'm like, because you know, I'm like, I'm about to lock this thing. Because in my head, bitch, I already know I'm about to lock this shit down. Like, y'all playing, keep it up, being with you. I know I was gonna get that dick. Not even gonna play with you, right? Not even gonna hold you on that. I was gonna get that dick, girl. So, so we sitting there, we conversating in person. You know, you can tell a vibe with a person. I just tell we was vibing on a different level in person, of course. We was talking about, you know, just everything and every, you know, where we been, what we doing, how's your first year out of high school? I was like, how's your first year? You know, just getting to know and what to do and how to do it, girl. You know, just talking and chit-chatting, girl. And, you know, again, I could just see the posture, like his posture. He was into me. Of course, I was into him, bitch, because I was just looking like, yo, what's up? So I'm into him. I'm like, yeah, so what's up? Stuff like that. I was sitting there, and then, you know, that awkward ass silence a little bit, like, was coming across, coming on a conversation. And I was like, so, this is where it gets juicy, y'all, so y'all listen up. So I said, so, you know, I've been having a crush on you ever since high school. And he said, you know, I'm talking real sweet, real sweet, we're high pitch. You know, I had a crush on you, my nail, you know, I had a crush on you, like, all high school, right? He was like, oh, word, really? I was like, yeah. I was like, I always thought you were cute. Your eyes were amazing. Like, that's what really got me into you was your eyes. And he was like, oh, word, like, thank you. Like, he's sitting out blushing and shit. You know, pretty bitches make niggas blush. It's almost like. So he like, oh, word. I'm like, yeah, you know, I'm pinning the Mac down, girl. Once I'm pinning the Mac down, Like, yeah, what's up with you? You know what I'm saying? I'm like, yeah, I thought we thought you cute. Your eyes really got me. He blushed and shit like that. And he like, word? I was like, yeah, word. He was like, damn, I mean, you know, I didn't really think about it like that. But you kind of cute now too, since I've seen you now. I'm like, oh, really? He's like, yeah, you know. I mean, I was bigger. I was skinnier, but I was as big as I was in high school, right? So yeah, I see you working, you know, da da da. I'm like, oh, word, like da da. I was like, yeah. He's like, oh yeah, word. You know, he said, I can see you moving and grooving. So, you know, just saying, I see you on your shit, and I respect that. And I was just like, yeah, I can see you on yours too. You know, coming here, you know, doing what you gotta do and like that. He's like, yeah, you know, I'm just trying to get my shit up, because you know, he's a basketball player in high school too. But he was just like, you know, just woken up now, right? I'm just like, okay, cool, it's like that. But again, he's still short. There's nothing wrong with short boys. People will be excellent. It's nothing wrong with short boys. I'm just having fun, girl. I'm just keen with y'all. And nothing wrong with short boys. I would still date a short boy. I had a crush on a short boy. So I still have a crush on a short boy. So don't get it misconfused. I had nothing against short people. But anyway. So he like, yeah. So basically, I'm saying all this to say, we feeling the vibe. And I was like, so I would really like to see you tonight. And that's where a bitch threw her fucking fish line in, girl. I said, I really want to see tonight. He was like, oh, word, do you? I was like, yeah, I do. And he was just like, oh, well, that's cool with me. I mean, if you want to come by. I said, yeah, that's A-okay with me. So, all right, cool. So he said, I'm gonna talk to you later. I'm gonna send you my addy on, well, I'm DM you my addy. And I said, all right, cool. So he left, he got up. Oh, sorry, before he got up, I was like, well, can I have a hug? And he's like, sure, whatever. And we hugged, girl, we hugged, girl. And I could feel all that meat on me and all that skin. I was like, bitch, you was on hard. I swear, that nigga was on hard, girl. I said, oh, bitch, I got my fish. And, you know, he's walking away. He's sitting there looking back. I'm looking at him walk away, girl. So it's just like, we're not serious. Bitch, I was sitting there grooving, bitch. Bitch, joking. Oh, I was so happy. So we got downstairs and like that. My mom finally came and I went home, right? And I went home and I had, of course, showered. This time, I cleaned myself out. I wanted to go for rounds this night, bitch. I knew I wanted to go fuck around. And I got the text from him. I was like, hey, this is my address. You can come around 11 something. My parents would be asleep because he was at his parents because he was visiting from college. He was like, yeah, da, da, da. You know, you just come at 8. I mean, come at 11. I got you, whatever like that. I said, cool. I'm going to open to your house. He said, all right, around 11. That's after me. I showered. I shaved. You know, everything a girl got to do to make sure she get ready for her dick appointment, I did. That was around 10. I called my Uber around 8. I mean, my Lyft around 10 something. So by the time I got there, it wouldn't have been 11. I got there like 11:15. I said, hey, I'm outside. He said, cool, just come on in. I went inside. I went to his room. And his room was so dark. Only light that was in there was a TV. I walked in. There was a TV light. And his bed was literally, the TV is right here. The bed is right here. So I walk in and I'm right here at the bed. And he was, he was right next to me. And here we go with the awkward shit. He was sitting next to me. I was sitting next to him. He was looking at me. I was looking at him, he was looking at me. It was just like, girl, we all know what we came here for. So why do niggas act like we, you know, I came here for a special reason. Now again, I'm be expecting niggas to make the first move because that's just me now. Because it's just like, yo, you want me? Show me you want me. I'm tired of being a folk dominant ass bitch. Now, it depends on a circum situation, but I'm tired of being the most dominant ass bitch in the fucking room. Like, nigga, pick my ass up and throw me against the fucking wall and tell me, bitch, I'm yours. You know what I'm saying? Like, girl, give me some aggressive ass shit. I'm tired of niggas. I gotta sit there and make the first move. Like, that shit is not, after a certain while, bitch, that shit don't get sexy. Like, I gotta make the first move and shit. Like, no, nigga, y'all be acting so fucking scared. Maybe I'm dealing with crappy ass niggas. That's probably why, too. Or I dealt with crappy ass niggas. Because nowadays, I ain't doing that shit no more. It's not just a lot of you. I fuck up a little bit. And I got a story time y'all coming soon about that. How I fucked up this recently. But besides that, girl, fuck that shit. So, anyway, let's get back to the story. Because I got off track. So, I'm sitting there and have to make the first move. So, I started touching on him. I was like, so, what's up with you? Dick already on hard. One thing about Enoch, I make a dick get hard, bitch. So, I'm sitting there making, you know, touching, feeling on him. And, you know, of course, he's starting to, like, relax. You know, I'm working his shirt off, working his drawers off. I'm taking my stuff off. Now, this time, I had hair in. So, you know, bitch is losing her fucking fantasy, girl. Hands up, my background's in here. Let's see her. Now my hair's like a 20. I think it was like a 22-inch. So I was just sitting there shaking my hair, girl. You know, just living, girl. Living my best fantasy, girl. My white girl fantasy. And I had a frontal. Oh, girl, she was really living. You know, I'm sitting there drawing like that. I'm pulling my hair back. You know what I'm saying? Just, ooh, I'm giving very much pin up, girl. I'm about to do this. I ain't new to this. You know what I'm saying? Just very much that, girl. I ain't had no boobs. Because, again, I was not on hormones back then. But I feel like I was just feeling my motherfucking pussy, bitch. That's just that on that. I was feeling my pussy. And he was feeling my pussy too. Cause bitch, that dick was up. So I'm touching feeling on him and your girl get to doing the legendary, iconic girl, mother of all mothers, dick sucking treatment, girl. That's what I'm gonna say, bitch. Your girl was living for the dick and the dick was living for her. Your girl was doing it. And, you know, of course, the nigga moaning and groaning and groaning and fucking even moaning, bitch. Boom. So I said, oh, bitch, I got him now. So we work our way up into the bed. You know, at this point, we in it to win it. I say, you got condoms? She said, yeah. He bought the condom. Boom, bam. Shellac, shapow. I say, you got lube? He said, oh, yeah, I got lube. He had lube with him. So I said, all right, okay, girl, this is really about to go down, bitch, because I want rounds. You understand me, bitch? I want rounds, bitch. So the first time we doing it, you know, he pin my condom, we doing it, I'm riding, my hair is going on the back of my back, girl, I'm shimmying, girl, I'm pinning my hands on his chest, on his throat, I'm grinding, girl, like a real Houston girl should. Like the city girls say, and I'm gonna ride you like a rodeo. Girl, I was doing a rodeo before they even coming with the concept. Girl, I was doing it. So, boom, next thing you know, he came. I said, all right, cool. He ended up coming. Of course, I guess he was kind of done with it. I wasn't done. Again, I wanted rounds. I'm keep saying that in the story because it's true, because the bitch wanted rounds. I wanted rounds. And the dick wasn't that big. My thing is, people, you know, I'm not really a size queen like other girls are. I'm not that type of girl. I'm not saying you can't be small. Like, I can't do shit if this lip gloss is big in your dick or you know, your dick is the same size as fucking lip gloss, I can't do shit with you. I'm sorry. I just can't, because it's turning me off. But I feel like from a 7-inch, this is for grown folk, from 7 inches and above, well, 7 to 8, 8 and a half, okay, we in a ballpark, girl, I'm living for it, what the fuck is that? But 7 and below or not, or 8 or 8 and a half and higher, I can't do. I want my walls, but I want to feed you my walls. So I feel like that's just a good thing for me. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm not trying to, and a girl is tight. A girl don't have that much sex that often. So it's just like, most of these stories, girls are spread apart. So don't think that a girl's out here fucking. Your girl ain't doing that. All these stories are like, you know, it's the time of my life, girl, months, years go by before I, you know, get to them. But anyway, but yeah, and he, you know, he wasn't too big. So after that, he came. He laid there for a while, took off the condom, we were sitting there, we're like that, you know, I'm sitting there with my little hair, with the sheets on top, you know, my little fake boobies, girl, just like, that was good. He's like, yeah, that was good. I said, yeah, that was real good. And I don't know why I did that shit, but I did. And I did like that, and he was like, you okay? I was like, yeah, I'm good. He's all right, cool. So at this time, he got up, and he had to go get something from the kitchen. I don't know what the fuck he was gonna get. He had a fucking soda, girl. That's what that was. He got a soda, bitch. What nigga is that? But anyway, he went to get. He got some soda, and he sat there because he asked me if I wanted water. I was like, nah, I'm okay. So he's just sitting there, drinking his soda like that, watching TV. At this time, at this point, we just sitting in bed together. We wasn't cuddling anything like that. We just sitting in bed together. And then some time went by, girl. This time around, it's like I got there like 11:15, girl. It's like probably 12. And I didn't have a curfew. So, did I sneak out? I think I snuck out, actually. I snuck out, so I didn't have a curfew. I did not have a curfew. So that came around. And again, my hair, I'm thinking, like, bitch, I'm gonna go again. So, I'll probably say I gave him enough rounds to, like, get his shit back up. And then I asked him, like, hey, you think you can go another round? He was like, I don't know. Blah, 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 blah. I'm like, oh, okay. So, we're just sitting there again watching what's on TV, and then your girl started making the first move again. So I started pinning my hand down his pants. He was like, what you doing? I'm like, I need another round. So I'm working my way on his pants again. At this point, I'm sucking him off again. He getting hard. Cause what Eli do? Getting niggas hard. So I'm working my way. I'm doing what I need to do to satisfy him. And we go at it again. This time around, again, I'm whipping my hair around. He ain't too big. Like, I can feel him in me. It's just, it really is. I ain't gonna lie to you, girl. That shit felt good. So, and this time, I was more controlled, too. And I was like, okay, well, he should be able to last longer because he came the first time. This time around, girl, we about to go for it. So, we doing it. And then, you know, he came again. This time, he came extra early. I was upset. I was sick, girl. I was really mad because I was just like, did I waste my time? Did I waste my time, girl? What the fuck is he? Did I waste my fucking time? Because I was mad because I wanted to go for at least 3 or 4 rounds. Second time. I was like, okay. And I asked him, because he came, he's like, oh. And after that, because he was still inside of me. Like, I mean, he had a condom on. Don't worry, he had a condom on. But I was like, I looked down at him. I was like, you think you can go again? He was just like, nah, I ain't gonna lie to y'all. No, sorry, you looking up. Nah, I don't think I can. I was like, okay. And then I got off. And then I'm sad thinking about it. I'm really sad thinking about it. I got off and I had, sat on the side of bed, girl, at this point. I was just like, where's the restroom? He says, over here. I'll clean myself off. I put my dress back on. And I just said, you know what? I'm gonna go ahead and head out. It was nice talking to you again, meeting you, whatever like that. He said, yeah, same to you. Have a good night. I said, cool. I went home the next day. I said to him again in the morning. I was like, hey, what's up with you? So about last night, how you feeling? That's just me as a person. I don't know why I want to check on these niggas. They don't give a fuck about you. They really don't give a fuck, but that's just me. I was like, so how was last night? How you go about last night? He was like, I feel okay with it. He said, can I be honest with you? I said, yeah, what's up? He was like, I don't think I want to do that again. I just kind of wanted to use you for an experience, and I got that, so I don't think, and I know that it's not for me, per se. But he said, like, we were, like, it wasn't, like, no douchebag ass shit, like, I mean, he didn't block me, he didn't, you know, it was just, like, a thing where it was, like, I, basically, he used me for experience, or he was curious or some shit, and he used me on that. At that time, I was, again, identifying as Taylor, but I was more on the boyish side of this girl, because, again, the girl was not on my own. So yeah, he was just like, you know, I think it's not for me, da da. So I'm like, cool, that was cool, right there. And after that, girl, we never talked again. So that's pretty much it. Yeah, that's pretty much end of story time. We stopped talking. I never really saw him again after that little hoorah we did that night, and that was pretty much it. I seen him on Instagram doing stuff, but after a certain point, I just unfollowed him because. What was the point, girl? I got what I wanted. And that sounds so oof, but if niggas can say it, I can say it. So bitch, yeah. So basically I got what I wanted today. That was it, girl. I ain't tripping about it no more. But yeah, that's pretty much Elma's story time. I love you guys. I thank you guys for tuning in again. I see y'all. I am growing. I am at 160 something subscribers right now. Thank you. I love you guys forever and ever and ever. On a road to 200. Maybe I can get 200 before the end of the year. That would be so kind. So, yes, ma'am. I love you guys. Thank you guys for tuning in. Please like, share, subscribe. Please keep up with me when I'm not on YouTube. All my social media will be in the description box below. If you have anything you want to leave or, you know, DM me personally, girl. Again, of course, you can always DM me on Instagram. I was on Instagram. Or you can just leave a comment down here or like that. And yeah, your girl is out. You need to tell my heavy. I try not to make it a habit, but I can't promise that. Wish I could do that. Cause you deserve actions and not words. And you know that I'm worth waiting for. While I'm out on tour, tell me right now. I'm